listen to this story. A friend of mine once received a phone call from his father. He's a busy man, my friend. You know, senior person in the corporate world, and his schedule is almost busy. Anyway, so he received a phone call saying, his father telling him that it was necessary that he visits his parents' home that evening because it was important. And the father did not elaborate. So anyway, so my friend had to reschedule his agenda and make sure that in that evening he's at his father's, you know, his parents' home. So he goes there, and what's the story? The story is the following. Apparently some salespeople knocked at the door of his parents' home in the daytime, in the morning, pretending or proposing that they were selling very expensive watches, gold watches, for $20. And that this was an amazing deal. So the father was so excited about this deal that he called his very busy son, senior executive son, to go home and capture this opportunity. So I leave it to you to imagine the face of my friend when he discovered why he was invited to his parents' home. Self-leadership, and leadership in general, especially self-leadership, in this highly complex and complicated world, cannot afford being naive or innocent. Now, the word innocent has a positive connotation. You know, we talk about innocence as a good virtue or something good, positive. But in some cases, unfortunately, it's a dangerous proposition. Because if you are naive and innocent in a jungle, guess what? You will end up being somebody's lunch or dinner. I'm not talking about being vicious. I'm not talking being Machiavellian. I'm not talking about being manipulative. I'm not talking about being malevolent or evil. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about being alert, being conscious, being smart, being intelligent, being realistic, being strong, being wise, being experienced. That's what I'm talking about. It's a matter of survival. If you don't do any of these, then your actual survival is at stake, let alone the opportunities. Word naive usually refers to lack of experience, lack of wisdom, lack of judgment. Take out any of these, then your context or your being is in danger. If you're in business, your business is in danger. If you're a father, then maybe your kids are in danger because you'll make bad judgments about, you know, their life. Whatever it is, you can't afford to be naive. Now, what do you do so that you're more realistic, you're more of a realist, and you save yourself from being naive? Or what do you do if you want to teach your kids or people around you, if you want to exercise leadership, teach them about not being naive, about being alert. When it is too good to be true, be careful. Let the alarm bells ring. Any situation when you feel it's too good to be true, the deal is too good to be true, a situation, an offer, some news, too good to be true, your gut is telling you this is too good to be true, then question marks, bing, 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 you know, alarm, that there's something that needs further observation here. Don't rush into accepting it as great news. It doesn't work like this. Sometimes, you know, one in, I don't know, so for several tens of millions win a lottery, but this is an exception. It doesn't work like this. Losing a lottery is the most common one. Winning a lottery is a rare event. So too good to be true, be careful. Be skeptical. not sarcastic, skeptical. Skeptical means you're not sure that this is right. So means investigation, means observation, means further probing, means not accepting anything for face value before you actually investigate in depth prior to accepting it. Don't trust easily. Some people even say, trust no one. I say, living a life where you trust no one is a horrible life, because you're always anxious, worried, and you're always looking behind your back, and it's just a horrible way of living if you trust no one. I mean, what? You don't trust your partner? Imagine living with your partner at home, whom you don't trust, or your kids, or your siblings, or your parents, or your secretary, or your staff, or your colleagues. Imagine if you're driving and you don't trust the drivers, you know, driving next to you. It's a horrible way of living. So what I would propose is, don't trust easily. Check and double check and triple check and observe if a person merits your trust. And then when that happens, trust, but always keep an eye, because, you know, surprises happen. And sometimes your calculations were not accurate. Read, read, read. The purpose of reading is to learn. The more you learn, the better judgment you can make, because you have more data, more experiences that you can build on. Other people's experiences, of course, provided that you know what you're reading. You're nourishing your mind, not contaminating your mind. So read, read, read. Self-development, as much as you can. Invest in yourself. It is the best investment ever. Invest in yourself, because you make fewer mistakes and you make much better decisions. Listen. There's so much data out there in what people say to you. And if you're really smart, you learn how to read between the lines. So listen. Just listen. And take that data in and analyze it. Do your own interpretations and measure it against other data, so that you have more information that will help you in making the right judgment, the right informed judgment, not the naive judgment. Don't rush into conclusions. Some people rush into conclusions. That's also dangerous. Why? Because rushing means you haven't listened enough, you haven't analyzed enough, you haven't diagnosed enough, you haven't reflected enough, you haven't thought enough, you haven't considered many options enough, you haven't investigated enough. So don't rush into conclusions before you make a decision or before you make a judgment. And the last point is, learn how to ask questions. Ask questions. Ask as much as you can. Ask questions to tackle the situation from different angles, so that you have, just like lighting, you know, when you're in the photography business, lighting is so important, because you have to make sure that the angles, most of the angles, at least the angles that you want, are properly covered by light. So ask, ask and ask and listen, especially to wise people. This is an extra point. Surround yourself with wise people whom you can go to, so that you can check and double check your thinking. It's like a sanity check mechanism. Ask wise people whom you trust. Should I do this? Is my interpretation correct? Is this news true enough? Should I trust that person? Am I thinking properly? Am I being oversimplistic? These are some of the steps that you can do to protect yourself from being naive. You can also use the same steps to teach people around you, whether at home or at work, on how to become more alert, with their eyes wide open, awake, so that the decisions that they make in life and the steps that they take are more informed. It is not a matter of choice, it's a matter of survival, because being naive is a recipe for suffering, for pain, for disappointment, and maybe it might even put your entire being at risk. And this is what self-leadership is supposed to protect you from. It's about survival and growth. And to do that, you cannot afford to be naive. Open your eyes wide open. And do the same with your mind and heart.